Alright guys, first of all, thank you so much for your wishes. My health is definitely recovering. And okay, so everybody on YouTube is fighting these days, and apparently with this video, I will be joining the bandwagon too. Trust me, I did not want it. But as a YouTuber, as a blogger, I need to protect my brand name, Superwowstyle. I need to make sure that my name, my images are being used at the right places. Now, see, what happens is that number one, my viewers trust me, okay? So if my face, or even if a part of my face is being used somewhere, if I don't know where my face is being used, my viewers might think that I'm actually endorsing their product. And they might end up buying that product, thinking that Prachi is saying, you know, out of their trust, they might buy something because they think I'm selling it. So obviously that is not right. Because my viewers are trusting me, I don't even know what they're trusting me for because my face is there. Number two, what happens is that I'm actually working with brands, I'm actually working with companies. So I need to know where my name, where my face, where my videos are being used and where my videos are being shown, right? So it's very important that my brand, my business gets protected for the benefit of my viewers, for the benefit of the brands that I work with. Now, this is a video I made about 1-2 years back. It's been a long time now. And this was a video thumbnail. Interestingly, a lot of you recognize just the bottom half of my face, and some people even message me on Instagram saying, Prachi, I saw your image somewhere. Are you working with this company or are you using their products? Have you given them the permission to use your picture? Things like that. So I'm like, okay, it's happening again because this happens all the time. Trust me. I get reports like that every single day. So I just write to these companies. I say, dude, remove my picture, man. It's not your picture. How can you steal my picture and use it like that? Remove my picture. So, you know, when I send them these messages, I get a bit angry. They get a bit scared. They get embarrassed because obviously they're doing something wrong. They apologize and they remove the picture. That is what they do. So it's like a daily thing for us. So as usual, I got angry. So I'll just actually, you know what, let me just move to the side so you can read this very interesting conversation. So I'll tell you. So I got a bit angry and I wrote to her. I could have been a bit more polite, but then again, if somebody's stealing stuff from you, you know, you can get a bit angry. So anyways, I wrote to her, please stop using my images to feature your products. I have never used your products and endorsed them. You have no right to use my images for such illegal promotion. Because it's an illegal promotion, right? When you're misrepresenting something and saying that, whatever, you know what I'm talking about. So then the reply comes, excuse me ma'am, which image are you referring to which I share this screenshot which was shared by my viewers. So this thing and this picture and everything comes out where it is saying that, you know, their brand name is there, their company website name is there, and it says hyperpigmentation, skin lightening, helps to remove dark patches around mouth, blah 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 blah. So clearly she's saying that, you know, because of my product this has happened. That is, I think, what is being intended by this picture. I think it was a story on their profile. So I'm like, what the hell is this? How can you use my pictures without asking me? I guess I could have been a bit more polite, I'll be honest. I didn't have to write what the hell is this. So yeah, I should have been more polite, I agree. So anyways, then she writes, in what way is that your image? I'm like, that is my image. If you're gonna act like it's not, I would be happy to send you a legal notice. It's from my YouTube channel, video thumbnail. Take it off from wherever it is being used and I would be happy to forget about this incident. Incident spelling is wrong because I was typing like really fast. And then I write, or else I would need to take action because obviously I cannot allow my images to be represented for such fraud businesses. Okay. Goodbye. And then I correct the spelling of incident because I'm like, okay, I can't write such a wrong spelling. So to this the reply comes, apologies if that's really your image. She's written apologies. That much she has given. So, congratulations. And then she's like, but if you're talking about legal threats, please go ahead because we haven't used any licensed images. It was available in Google as an open image for mouth pigmentation. And as a matter of fact, how dare you call our organization as fraud? In that terms, we can file a lawsuit against you. So, mind your words, miss whoever you are. This is where I really lost it. If she had just apologized and said, you know, it's okay. I mean, I was talking in an angry way, so it's understandable if she got a bit angry too. But then you cannot say that it was available on Google as an open image and you can use it. Now, anybody can take, this is something that I think everybody should know. I mean, people who usually run businesses, they have the common sense to know this much. Apparently, this one does not. So let me tell this to the lady from Jiore who I was talking to. First of all, I'm not Miss Whoever You Are. My name is Prachi. I'm a blogger. I have been doing this for 6 years and I know my business damn well. Okay. Now, when you are taking images from Google, just because Google is, you know, giving you those images does not mean that you have the right to use it. You have to check. Even Google will tell you that you have to check and you have to ensure before using it for commercial reasons. If you are educated enough to have your own company, you should have the common sense and the education to understand what your rights are. Okay. So I just said, send your full company name and address, please. You will get your legal notice this week with some real social media promotion that you want. Now, this is a real social media promotion that she wanted. You wanted to use my images for your social media promotion. There you have it. So she has given her address and her name, which I have blurred out because I don't think that would be right to put up. I have a problem with the company. I don't have a personal problem with you. So I want to keep that demarcation clear. Then I have even mentioned Google images are, by the way, not royalty free. Need to learn something about the law. Again, wrong spelling because I was angry. And the organization is fraud because you misrepresent your products. So then she's like, Miss, you should consult your legal team before addressing. I am Mrs. Okay. And I have a husband who has actually supported you over here. Let me come to that later. Showing images that have not been created using your products, I sure as hell will. I deal with people like you every day who think they can fraud. Okay, I don't know what I was writing. Sorry about that. Again, I'm letting you know this conversation is recorded in form of screenshots. So I've written something. I don't know what I've typed. So very sarcastically, she gives me a heart image. And then after this whole conversation, after a while, I actually spoke to my husband and I'm like, dude, I want to send her a legal notice. And, you know, because this is something that bloggers have to, you know, keep doing. We keep sending legal notices here and there. It's a daily thing for us. But then in this case, I was like, yeah, such a small company. She has like 4,000 followers on her Instagram and a small new company. And I'm like, dude, I mean, do I really want to get into a legal battle with these people? They're like, so anyways, I tried to still sort out the issue. I told her that I'll be sharing screenshots of this conversation in my upcoming YouTube video, which is this. In case you don't want that to happen, you can send an apology and confirm that my images shall not be used again. And then I write, I really don't want to fight, but your attitude is really disrespectful. She's like, not gonna happen, darling. And then something. So I don't wanna read out this thing. If you want, you can actually see what the rest of the conversation happened and how things happened. So that was a conversation that happened, and I just thought I should make a YouTube video about it and let everybody know. And more than letting everybody know, I should let Jiore official, by the way, your company name I don't like at all, but that's okay. I don't like my channel name as well. I mean, what the hell is Superwowstyle, right? I mean, when I started my YouTube channel, I don't know what I was thinking, and every day I'm like, dude, why did I call my channel Superwowstyle? Anyways, I'm not trolling myself in this video today. That's probably for some other time. It's time to troll you, jiore.official. Just remember that we bloggers work really hard, you know, and while I understand that everybody today thinks that they can download images from Google and use them in whatever way that they want and you have the right over everybody, that is not how things work. If you want to grow your business, get a photographer, get your models, take your own pictures and showcase your images, showcase your products using that. Don't just look for these shortcuts and do illegal stuff like, you know, this and then fight with people and have the humility to apologize when you're doing something wrong. You're stealing something from somebody, you know. For me, my images, my video, it's an asset. So when you steal that, that's stealing something from me. When you steal something from somebody, there's no harm in apologizing and accepting that you've done something wrong. If you're going to keep representing your company like this, God help you, seriously. As for the legal notice, I'm still thinking about it because I don't know if you are worth it or not. And you have mentioned that you can sue me for calling a business fraud. By all means, do it. And yeah, that's my husband. he's getting irritated because I'm wasting so much of time on somebody like this who means absolutely nothing. But then, yeah, I thought this video was important. So, yeah, anything you want to say to these people? They're called Jiore Official.
Sorry, what? Hi, guys. Sorry, I'm barging in again. What are we talking about?
Jiore Official. People Jiore. Who think they can just take our stuff like that. And,
hey, that's not good, huh? If I was you, I would sue them. It's IP.
But you just told me that I should not waste my time because they're nobodies and I should.
No, that is true, but then they shouldn't throw tantrums also.
Throwing tantrums? I mean, she's like, she calls me Miss Whoever
IP
you are.
IP is important.
You know, Miss Whoever you
IP
are.
IP is very important, this.
I mean, look at the attitude. And oh, you know, last message me, she's like, I don't have time handling spam messages. And I didn't come back to India to handle this. So she's like, oh, I'm from outside India, so I'm more important than you are.
How difficult is it to go outside India?
Do you really think you can impress somebody or, you know, make somebody feel like threatened? I mean, if that's your achievement, dude, trust me, that's not what sells a business.
Chalo, we'll go
Chalo,
out and celebrate
something. Let's celebrate, yeah? And I'll put this video up today. Or should I wait till evening, right? In case she changes her mind, in case somebody drills some sense.
I don't think she will.
I don't think she will, but I believe in giving second chances. I mean, even sometimes people learn, so. Okay, I'll wait till evening till the video goes live and then I'll take this live. Bye.